Hello all, welcome to the LED TV service course. In this first part, let us disassemble a 32-inch LED television and let us know the parts inside. In the second part, we'll know how to replace the motherboard. Let us open the back cover of the LED television. This LED television is a common one, not a branded one. Inside this, you'll see a single board. This is a combo board. SMPS backlight LED driver and motherboard all are in the same board. In some of the branded TVs, SMPS will be separate. In this board, it is a combo board. At the center, you'll see a black cable which is LVDS. At the lower part, a IR sensor and key controller connector is there. And the top one is for the backlight LED. This LVDS cable goes to the bottom where you'll see a long board. This is the scanner board. In some branded TVs, there will be a TCON board along with scanner board. In this, there is only a scanner board, long board. LVDS cable is connected to this scanner board. You can see this right end red wire type. This position is very important. In this type of LED, this is LVDS cable. Right end is power. And apart from the power, you will see 5 pair of twisted wires. These 5 pairs are 0 minus 0 plus up to 4 minus 4 plus. This is for data, LVDS to panel data. This LVDS cable goes to the motherboard and it is connected to the LVDS connector. Take care, there is an arrow mark on the board and the red wire has a dot on the connector. The dot should match the arrow mark. The lower end IR sensor and key controller connector has two parts. One part goes to the IR sensor and the other part goes to the keyboard. And there is also a four wire speaker connector. This stereo system, so there will be two speakers. This connector goes directly to the two speakers. And at the top there is two wire which goes to the panel, inside the panel. This is backlight driver. This has got around 40-50 voltage. It goes to the backlight. Under the motherboard you'll see printing hot and cold. This hot section is SMPS section and it has high voltage. Be careful while operating with this. And even this capacitor will hold voltage even if the power is remote. This is the AC power connector. And mains cord is connected directly to this connector. The lower end is the IR sensor and keyboard connector. Center one is the LVDS and the top one is the backlight. So this combo board has got only a simple wiring. Now let us open the top bezel. Remove the screws of the LED TV from the back side and then remove the top bezel. At the bottom there is a scanner board. So remove the tape that is pasted to the panel. You can while replacing, you can use the same tape. Just remove the tape. Be careful while handling with the panel. So the scanner board, you just fold it and put a tape. So that the strip wires are not damaged. Now lift the panel carefully. While handling the panel, you should be very careful. It is fragile. TV panel is fragile and it is like glass. Keep it in a safe place. And then remove the screws of the bottom support frame. And then remove the support frame of the panel. Below the support panel, you can see two sheets of plastic which acts as a reflector and a light filter. If you lift this two sheets, beneath that you can see the backlight bulbs. In this model, there are three rows of backlight bulbs, which is covered by a white sheet that is fixed with screws. In some other models, it will be fixed with locks. You have to remove the screws to see the backlights. Now let us remove the screws and lift the white sheet that is covering the backlights. This is the backlight strip. In this model, there are only three rows of backlight strips. In some other models, up to 8 rows are there. This is 6 LED backlight. 3 numbers are there. Now let us replace one by one to fix it properly back. Now replace with the backlight cover and then place the screws intact. Take care that all LED bulbs are facing up clearly, and then place the reflector and light filters sheets. And then place the LED panel frame. In some models it is clip type, press to lock. In this model it is screw type. Place the LED frame and then put all the screws. Now reinstall the LED panel. You should be very careful while reinstalling the LED panel. Place it properly onto the support and take care that edges are very carefully inserted. Do not press much. If even if there is a small crack and the whole LED panel is gone, you have to buy a new one. It is very difficult to get. So take care while replacing the LED panel. Paste the tape and remove the tape on scan drive board and get them back into correct position. Now place the final top bezel. Press fit to the proper position and take care that LED panel is seated properly inside. This is the final top bezel. Now you can flip the TV to see the backside. Flip it gently. And then at the back side, you have to put all the screws. In this model, there are a lot of screws. You put all the screws. And this is the scanner board. At the bottom, you can see the scanner board. Here, you have to connect the LVDS cable. It'll go to one side only, one direction only. The red, this right side red wire connection. Fix it properly, LVDS. The other end of the LVDS cable goes to the center of the motherboard. Take care to match the dot with the arrow. The top one is the LED backlight driver wire. Connect it back. At the bottom you can see the IR sensor and the key controller connector. Press fit it. This is the IR connector. You have to fix it to the at the bottom. At the side you can see the key controller. Press fit the AC mains cord. Now in the second part we'll see how to replace the motherboard. Thank you.